Once upon a time lived a woodcarver named Geppetto. He made puppets from pieces of wood and he called his favorite puppet Pinocchio. I would love to be a father to real boy like Pinocchio, he wished. That night the blue fairy who knew Geppetto was a good man caused a magic spell over Pinocchio. The very next day, Geppetto awoke and was very happy to find that Pinocchio could waltz, sing, and talk like a real boy. Geppetto went to send Pinocchio to school. He sold his only coat for a spelling book. "Now you can go to school like a real boy," said Geppetto, as we waved goodbye to Pinocchio. On the way to school, Pinocchio stopped to watch a puppet show in a town. "Hey, would you like to join my puppet show?" asked the evil puppet master. Pinocchio happily agreed. He was locked inside the evil puppet master's caravan. He wished he was safe with Geppetto. The blue fairy suddenly appeared. She had heard Pinocchio wish and set him free. Pinocchio is happy to be free. "I'm going straight to school," he said. But he met an evil fox who told him all about a wonderful place called Fun Island. Pinocchio forgot all about the school and gave the fox his spelling book in return for a ticket to Fun Island. "Where are you going, Pinocchio?" asked the fairy. "I'm on the way to school," lied Pinocchio. Pinocchio's nose grew very, very long. He wished he hadn't told Ali. The fiery colored appeared to peck off his long nose because Pinocchio was very sorry. Pinocchio promised never to be naughty ever again and went straight to school. At the school, Pinocchio told his friend about Fun Island. His friend wanted to go with him. Pinocchio and his hurriedly climbed aboard a ship that was going to Fun Island. On the island, they didn't know the little boys were turned into donkeys and used for very hard work. Pinocchio cried and wished he hadn't come to the island. He also wished he didn't look like a silly donkey. The blue fairy had heard his wish and with a wave of her magic wand, his donkey ears and tail disappeared. Pinocchio sat on the shore, sadly looking out to sea. He wondered if he would ever see Geppetto again. Suddenly, he saw Geppetto, who had sailed out to sea in search of Pinocchio. Geppetto didn't see the huge whale behind him. The whale swallowed Geppetto and his boat. Pinocchio knew he had to save Geppetto. He jumped into the water and sang with on his mic. As he got closer, the whale opened his mouth and Pinocchio swam right in. Deep inside the whale's belly, Pinocchio and Geppetto hugged each other, happy to be gathered again. "We must find a way out," said Geppetto. "We will make a fire from the wood of my boat." The smoke made the whale sneeze. They shoot out of the whale's mouth and back into sea. Pinocchio and Geppetto swam softly to shore. They were both tired. They lay on the sand and fell asleep. When Geppetto woke, he saw that the blue fairy, as a reward for being so brave, had turned Pinocchio into a real boy. "At last, my wish has come true," cried Geppetto.